camera's fully zoomed in, 320 240 resolution, set to infinity. Again, camera fully zoomed in, 320 240 resolution, set to infinity. Final test. This is outdoors in daylight. Moving back away from the direction of the sun. The sun is now almost behind me. All camera settings are the same. Zoomed out to 70 millimeters, no digital zoom. And now the sun is directly above me and behind me. This will be our final shot or test for today. There we go, looking at the tree. Moving towards the direction of the sun on this clip, so the colours may be a bit washed out because of the overexposure, and it's facing into the sun now. Okay, this is a different setting. See if that improves things or not. So, there we go. Sun behind me. Go back the other way. And up towards our tree. If we can. See if we can improve the picture quality at all. Resolution 160 to 120. We're set on infinity. And compression is set to super. As can be seen by today's standard, recording on this device is very poor, but it's only fair to point out it was never really intended as a serious video recording device. It's just a single shot camera. It stands in its own league as regards JPEGs are concerned and single shots. We will continue with these in our next test. and of course we're now back to 1.5k on my telephone. Just thought I'd look around this little bit of a bush so you could get some idea of the difference between 2 megabits and 1.5k megabits. The advantage of course being able to zoom in and out whilst the video is actually recording. As you can see there, that's all the way in. Let me give you some idea of what the difference is in between the two. I apologise for the camera shaking. I still haven't yet bought a tripod for it. As previously mentioned in a different video. Let's just see if I can resolve that issue as soon as possible. Give me some insight. Incidentally, that noise in the background is a bus coming in. This is just along the street from where I live. On the bus stop. All this foliage is just around the edge of the bus stop. Just to give you some idea. Anyhow, I'm going to have to close this now, and I hope you enjoyed this video and had some fun trying to work out which camera took which image. Bye for now. Look forward to the next one.